Hello everybody, I'm back and I'm not playing Shogun 2 this time. If you're concerned, do not be, and it's... I'm gonna be finishing off Shogun 2 and probably keep playing more of it. But this time around, I just felt like playing something new, you know, because I figure... probably get boring for everybody if I just played the one game all day, every day. So we're gonna play some Blood Bowl. Now don't worry, this one hopefully won't turn into me explaining how the game works. So I'm just gonna jump into it. So as you can see, I have played this game. So
I'm always ready for
these two teams I created but haven't played yet. And these two teams I actually rather like. As I'm sure you can see just by looking at it. Have not played it much. This is another instance of me being not really that great at video games. So we're gonna go with the Nurglite Brawlers. It's because it's a Nurgle team, which weirded me out because I don't remember there being specifically a Nurgle team. I remember there being Chaos, because that's one of my other teams, but I don't remember there being a Nurgle team, which is, you know, new and interesting. And then, of course, there's Nagash's Legacy, which is just a regular undead team, not a vampire team, which I don't remember if they separated them out. I remember these guys, the Necromantic, but I also remember the Necromantic having goblins in them, not... ghouls, so I feel like there was a massive reworking at some point when I wasn't paying attention. So we're just gonna go with, I don't know, because I figure we'll play through a league and then see how it goes.
How's the missus?
So we'll go with the Nurglite Brawlers. No, fuck it. Let's just build an entirely new team and go through there.
Sacred gut plate, the cow.
Yeah. Let's see. Humans, orcs, dwarves, skaven, high elves, dark elves, Bretonian, chaos, lizardmen, Norse, undead, necromantic, Nurgle. So, I kind of want to try and play a passing team, which I believe would be the high elves. Let's check out what people the Dark Elves have, in case it's not clear by the teams that I already have in existence. I like playing bad guys. What do we call this? What's their name? What's his name? Malaketh? Yeah, it's Malaketh and his mother. Lithuanian Renegades, Naggaroth Nightwings. Oh, Naggaroth is a good thing to base it on. I kind of like this color scheme too. So, you know what, let's go with Naggaroth something or other. Oops, shit's falling over on my table. Let's go with Naggaroth. You know what? How about, fuck it, we'll go with Brides of Naggaroth. Now, I know not all the members
Goblin
of this team are going
to
be female.
A great company to be affiliated with. Any problems you may have are surely
I'm not sure if I should turn him off
Isn't
or
that
not.
The company that you owe a great deal of bad gambling debts to?
That has nothing to do with my spontaneous endorsement.
Yeah, I think I'm going to have to turn them off, sadly. Because I'm not playing this solo on my own for once. I'm recording, so I think I'm going to have to turn them off. But yeah, so I know they're not all going to be women, but you know what? They're Dark Elves. They could be brides if they want to be. And then team motto, I don't know. Honor to... Hard times, fun women. There we go. Let's do it that way. Why not? And of course, we're going to have to pick Nagaroth. Let's see. We'll call it the... let's go on a unoriginal, the Bride Bowl. Or the Bride Bowl. The Bride Bowl. Actually, kind of like how that sounds. And then, no, I'm not going to let my assistant just build my team for me.
A dark elf team is a wise choice, especially if you like speed and violence.
The assassin is a dark elf special unit. His dagger allows him to easily injure opposition players. And stab does what? This player may attack an opponent with their stabbing attack instead of throwing a block at them, making an unmodified armor roll for victim to score a piece of his armor value. Injury roll must be made. If stab is used as part of a blitz action, the player cannot continue moving after using it. Okay. How many assassins can I have? Two? Then blitzers do block. Then you do dodge, jump up in frenzy. Then you do dump off. What is dump off? This skill allows a player to make a quick pass when an opponent declares that he will throw a block at him. Passing agility general. It looks more like this team's a running team, which... Yeah, I think this team's more of a running team. Though with the agility and movement allowances... Yeah, this team's a running team. But... Yeah, fuck it. No, we're not going to do this one. Because I want to play a passing team. Yeah, Brad's and Nagaroth. No good. Create new team. Let's see. Now, humans can be runners, but they're boring. Or passers, but they're boring. Orcs.
Yeah.
Orcs.
I've got my McMurdy squig burger.
Hold on.
And my XXXL size cheese.
Okay, sorry guys, I'm gonna have to turn you off. Sounds. Comic volume. Turn you off. Activate subtitles, turn off. Subtitle. Or save. Then play leak. Okay. Let's see, create new team. So, no passing game on the undead. The Norse have a passing game. Strength for a team with a propensity for violence. Your players are almost naked, so their armor value is low. Strength skills are hard to obtain. Lizard men don't do passing. Chaos. I already have a chaos team, so not with that one. This one. No. Dark elves. High elves. And Skaven. A true running team. No, that's not what I'm after. Dwarf. Aim for defense and exhausting the opponent. They can beat any kind of opponent when it comes to a fight. Swift as snails. Basic players are expensive even if they're good. The death roller. Which we wouldn't use, probably wouldn't use at all. Alright, let's see. I think we're gonna have to play High Elf. Unless we end up doing Dark Elf anyway. Because the two runners can still be passers. Yeah, let's just do Dark Elf. So we're just gonna quickly edit out just the rebuilding of this team. So, 1 second, I'll be right back. Alright, and here we are, back to where we kind of started. So what we're going to need is I'm probably going to want both witch elves obviously to look after the ball, because she's got dodge, she's got jump up, stands for free without paying three skills for movement, block action while prone, which requires an agility modifier. If okay, dodge and frenzy. Yeah. So we're gonna get both of you. Oh, I might have to come back and look at them, because you can do some slight customization on them by changing the heads, but it looks like, because they look exactly the same, I think the hair got bigger maybe. Anyways, so let's see. Do I want assassins? So I'm definitely going to need runners. Whoops. Didn't mean to. Definitely going to need runners. Definitely going to need blitzers. The question is whether I need an assassin or not. So we're at 8. If I get 3 linemen, then let's go with like 1 assassin. Oh, no more gold. Alright, I guess we won't play with the assassin, just cause... See, I think they're going to... I feel like they're gonna get, like, at halftime, they'll just be removed from the game anyway. Because they'll just get a red card, you know what I mean? So if we confirm purchases, and we don't get any rerolls, huh? Actually, hold on, back. Wait, cancel purchases. God damn it. This isn't what I wanted. You know, fuck it. We'll just go without rerolls. Yeah, okay. So, this is gonna be a hard climb. Join a league, solo. We'll just play in a cup for now, which is my sort of testing ground. If they can't win cups, I don't send them up higher, and it's like... Okay. The Wandering Pickaxes. Underworld Denizens. Underworld Denizens. I think that's one of the... Yeah, that's the... That's one of the DLC teams that's Goblins and Skaven. That sucks. My very first outing, and the team is also based around agility and dodging and shit. So I have 10,000, which won't get me anything, because I don't think anything costs 10,000. Because I know you can spend your own money on, like, winning on these inducements, but I prefer to just spend the petty cash. Alright, let's see how this goes, because I am not foreseeing a good time to be had for us. Did you know the official record for the most players dismembered by a referee is held by ex-Reaver Blitzer Max Kneecap Middleman? If you used to follow the NAF referee's guidelines, never read him, have I? And dispense summary justice on the pitch with a pair of pliers, a branding iron, and a chainsaw. The latter was only used for arguing the ref calls. Kneecap was sacked after 3 games, but the NAF was forced to reinstate him due to pressure from the fans. Kneecap claims, "I never threatened him with me chainsaw honest." Oh my god. Warming up the Necromancer transmitter. Like, I don't get the loading times in this game sometimes. Sometimes it takes like no time at all, and other times it takes like forever. So one. Okay, so we have the Brides of Naggaroth. Show the two Witch Elves, because I just remembered that I kind of wanted to... Yeah, they look exactly the same, so I don't want to change their heads. Even the customization is just changing the head. And then we have the Wandering Pickaxes. Some Skaven. And then a bunch of Goblin. And a fucking Troll. The Troll's gonna be a pain. Oh dear.